Alright, good morning everybody. Day one on a road trip across western United States. We stopped in the middle of nowhere, right at the border of Utah, at McClendon Springs, historical site of the California Trail. Truly an oasis in the desert. Obviously, somebody needs a little help when it comes to spelling. Or maybe we're just in a giant ice cream sundae. How we doing, Younger G? Well, Baby G, a GoPro is Daddy's new toy. And right now, Baby G, we have arrived at Yuba State Park. How's Mrs. G surviving over there? She's been stuck in a car with me for hours upon end, so that's a struggle for anyone. Nice little campsite. A lot of stuff still closed as it's only March 18th, but very clean little campsite. So hopefully we'll get to meet up with some friends a little bit later. And of course, somebody's decided to buy this piece of property and put a giant house right on the reservoir.
Continue for 3/4 of a mile.
Here's something you don't see every day. Camel. In Utah, in the middle of nowhere. We are 100 miles from anywhere. In the middle of the desert in Utah. On our way to Mesa Verde, Colorado. You know, we've been in Utah a few times, but never down this route. The drives here never fail to amaze. Always nice.
Kind of
looked bigger in the movie. It's quite the little canyon.
But where are the houses?
No houses at this spot, Baby G. We must continue on. So here you can see one of the pit homes they would have built in around 550 CE. But then throughout time, they went from making simple mud pit homes to larger, more complicated stone structures like the ones we were looking at earlier. What do you guys think of all these structures?
Pretty amazing.
So Harlow says rawr. Mom says amazing.
They are pretty cool.
Yes, I said yes.
You did? Cool.
Yeah.
So, we bagged one of these bad boys. Thankfully, a warning from the lovely guys at the BLM. For our last site, closed through April 30th. Yep, a lot of stuff is closed, so that's why we headed south. Although you can still see a bit of snow up there. Not bad. Check out this cool natural amphitheater on the side of this canyon wall. Let's go check it out. What's up here, guys? An echo point. I hear chirping. Hello. Whew. All right, boys and girls, we are currently opting to stay at a Motel 6 in Santa Fe because it is cold, it is snowing, and no one in my family has had a shower in 3 or 4 days. So I think we deserve the luxury accommodations of the Santa Fe Motel 6. This video is not endorsed by Motel 6. If you find yourself in need of giant lawn ornaments, Santa Fe has got you covered.
What are you doing?
Did you enjoy the Santa Fe Brewing Company?
It was so good.
You enjoyed your adult beverages?
It was really good.
Like I was waiting for you in the parking lot, like a stalker.
It scared me a little bit.
Well, guys, gals, I think it's day 5, maybe. And today the G unit is visiting Bandalier National Monument. And it looks like we've got a big old canyon to check out first thing. We're gonna head over to Taos later today. Taos. I have no idea if I'm saying it right. We are winging this trip pretty hard, so one day at a time. So there was an ancient volcanic eruption like thousands of millions of years ago. I guess it left like hundreds of feet of this volcanic tuff, which was really easy to dig into, which ancestral Pueblo people made a lot of homes and storage right in the hillsides, as well as large adobe villages, so we'll go check it out. Looks like we can actually go into the cliff dwelling, so we will go check it out. Let's do it. So this is that volcanic tuff that the ancient Pueblo used, and you can see, like, just my fingers, not even fingernails, you can carve right into the hillside, making it the perfect place to be able to build using simple stick and stone tools to excavate cavates, which I'm not making it up, that's what they're called. Let's go check it out. How much square footage are we looking at up there? Can you imagine having to, how many ladders you'd have to use to get to some of the upper floors? And all the doors were built into the ceiling for the actual structures, because if they put doors or windows in the walls, the stone wasn't strong enough, it would collapse. That, or maybe it was a defensive mechanism. That would be a lot of climbing every day. You'd have wicked good cardio. Now down below here, you can see one of the multi-room pueblo structures. These are usually circular shaped, so there'd be a big courtyard in the middle. You can see a kiva there, an underground structure as well. So a lot of these were over 100 rooms. I really didn't realize how sedentary and agricultural Southwest Pueblo civilizations were in the early, you know, between 700 AD and like 1200 AD. You can see where they would have built this buildings right into the cliff face and the holes for the timber beams that would have made the roofs and the floors between floors. Well, that's where we're going next. No regrets. We did not bring the kids up there. So. Worse than the hanging suspension bridges in Nepal, or better?
Better.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
But it was no joke.
Yeah, it was steep. So Google Maps thought it would be a good idea when we were heading west from Bandalier National Park to send us 8,000 feet up into the mountains and then have the road go from being paved to a snowed-in Forest Service road. So, as you can see, as you can see, we had to do a little bit of a U-turn because even with four-wheel drive, there was no way I was backing up and turning around out there. What'd you think of that road?
Harsh.
Yeah, indeed. Storm rolling in on the valley. You can hear the thunder. Let's see if we can get ahead of it and find somewhere to camp where we're not going to get dumped on or flooded in a flash flood. You can hear it in this video, but this is the most washboardy stretch of road I've ever driven on. So it's taking a minute to get to Chaco. Some stray cows. Say hi to the cows, everybody.
Hey, the baby cows!
Oh, they're gonna get hit.
Hi, cow. The baby cows!
Yeah, they are baby cows. Well, after the world's roughest road, we got to the Chaco Canyon campground, Guyo campground, and got like the almost last site. Couldn't pay because they don't have envelopes, so we got to go to the visitor center in the morning and pay that. So we're going to do Chaco, which is somewhere that way. But right now, we need to feed our humans. Get the old tent trailer set up again. All right, guys. We are at Chaco National Historical Park today, which is maybe the biggest collection of ancestral Pueblo artifacts, homes, kivas, anywhere in the United States. So we've already done Mesa, Verde, Bandalier, but Chaco is kind of the cultural center of all of it. So we're going to go check out maybe one of the largest construction projects in North America in pre-Columbian times. I mean, just look how many of those super flat pieces of sandstone they mortared together with mud to build these ones were referred to as these small homes, which some of them were still over 100 rooms. Well, I may be wrong, but we're gonna be checking out Pueblo Bonito. Maybe the biggest pre-Columbian structure ever made. So this is what it might have looked like in the 1100s. By the year 1200, most archaeologists and historians agree that drought, climate change, and using up most of the wood in the region forced these guys to move to wetter and better climates. But let's go have a look. You are approaching the great ruins of an ancient Indian fortified town, Pueblo Bonito. The structure was unearthed between 1920 and 1927 by the National Geographic Society. Gilbert Grosvenor, president, and the Smithsonian Expedition. Here she is. It's pretty massive. Usually we think of Native Americans as just nomadic. Obviously these guys had large settlements and grew crops and stayed here for a very long time and had some sort of government structure to organize building something on this big of a scale. Can we go inside? Let's have a look. You can see they had to make the walls pretty thick to build this tall. Ooh, these guys actually have doors as well. Let's go in.
How dark is there?
Is it dark in here, baby G?
Oh, there, Daddy, look in there.
Cool.
Oh, wait, I do.
Nice. Yeah, these would have been super dark. Hey, there is not a single window in there. Quite the maze of tunnels back here, guys. Yeah, this is an absolutely massive installation where probably hundreds of people would have lived here, and even more would have gathered for ceremonies, trading, etc. Look at all the big kivas we've got as well. This is huge. Crazy to think that when people were living in this, it's like right in the dark ages in Europe. What a wild time. This big landslide here happened a while ago. Fortunately, stopped just short of crushing some of the tallest parts of the Chaco structure. I am. I'm coming, baby G. So we are out here in the busy wilderness and everything looks like a different planet, like we're on Venus. What kind of mineral that is, I have no idea.
Well, this is a misty wilderness. There's lots of places to camp out here because it's uglier than the surface of the moon. Let's get out of here.
Well, G-Unit has been on the road for an entire week. Can you tell? We're all a little bit grungy. And right now, we are somewhere in northwestern New Mexico. I think we're going to drive over into Arizona and go to a park called Kodachrome. Now, if you find yourself in northern New Mexico and you're like, where is there to camp? Because it's a wasteland, there's nothing. We did find a really cool off-road vehicle park north of Farmington, which was good fun. Both the little G-units got to do some off-roading. Sadly, no video because my battery was dead at the time. So, onwards we go. Well, because we were passing through, we're gonna go bump by Four Corners Park, that totally arbitrary boundary where four states all intersect. Let's check it out. Well, after an entire day of driving out of New Mexico, like 8 hours, we've arrived in Kodachrome, Utah, in Bryce Canyon, and one of maybe the nicest campgrounds I've ever been on. Full hookups on the trailer, showers, laundromat, super nice ranger, and it's absolutely beautiful. This whole region was great. The drive-in was great. I wish we'd spent the whole trip here. We're gonna have to come back, but let's go check it out. Hello! I think we've reached the end of this box canyon. So much greener than in New Mexico. So much greener. Well, it's the final day of our adventure, and I packed the towels, so Mrs. G had to improvise.
I'm out of here.
How was your run today?
Awesome.
Yeah, all right. Little G's. Are you all ready to drive?
Yeah, we're gonna drive back home.
All right, let's do it. Gas station stop number one of the day. Gas, $4.54. Gas station stop number two. Gas price, $4.37 per gallon. And we have how many miles left to go today? Out of our almost 600, we have 384 to go. All right, guys. Third and final fuel stop. $4.39 a gallon. After this, we should have enough fuel to make the 237 miles home. Yeah, that is if this would pump. Come on. Pump.